Hello. Now let's discuss short run and long run. Production takes place in short period as well as in long period of time. So short run is it refers to the period in which output can be changed by changing only variable factors. Now let's see what are variable factors. Labor, raw materials are variable factors. Land, machinery, equipment or fixed factors. So in short run, output can be changed by changing only variable factors. We cannot change the factory site, or we cannot change the factory, or we cannot change the machinery, change the technology. Whereas in long run, it refers to a time in which output can be changed by changing all factors of production, that is land, labor, capital, raw materials, and all the factors of production can be changed. Then second point in short run, it uses both variable factors and fixed factors. Just now I said fixed factors, machinery, land, whereas variable factors, labor and raw materials. So the short run uses both. In long run, all factors are variable because you can increase. When you increase the supply, you can increase the machine, the site, factory site, and you can buy more machinery, you can change the technology, you can employ more labor, and you can use more raw material. So all factors are variable in long run. The third point in short run, demand is more active in price determination because supply cannot be increased immediately with increase in demand, because you have a restriction that only variable factors can be changed. So here what happens, when demand is more, that decides the price. In long run, you find both demand and supply play equal role because you increase the supply by increasing the factors of production. So both play equal role in price determination. So these are the points regarding short run and long run. So we have seen short run, long run, variable factors and fixed factors. Now let's see what is total product. So when you say total product, total quantity of goods produced by a firm during a given period of time with the given number of inputs. So inputs are fixed. So with that, in a particular period of time, you are making so many quantity of goods. So that is a producer mix. So that is what the total product. For example, 10 labor making 60 kgs of rice. So the total product is 60 kg. Now what is average product? Output per unit of variable input. That means total product divided by units of variable factors. So total product here, you find 60 kg of rice, and where variable factor is 10 labor. So 60 divided by 10 is equal to 6 kg. So 6 kg is the average product. The next one, marginal. So what is marginal product? Addition to total product when one unit of variable factor is employed. So as and when you extend one unit of factor by variable factor, the quantity you make, that is addition to the total product. What you make, you get from one unit of variable factor employed. Addition, so let me repeat, what is marginal product? Addition to total product when one unit of variable factor is employed. So here you find total product of n number of times minus total product of n minus 1. So TP, total product, n is number of times. So TP n minus 1, that is total product of n number of times minus 1, that is n minus 1 number of times. So that gives you the value of marginal product. So here 10 labor makes 60 kg of rice, 11 labor makes 67 kg. So the answer is 67, that is number of times, total product of number of times is 11. So what is the product? 67. 67 minus total product of 67, that is 11 number, 11 labor you are minus 1. So you get 10. For 10 labor, what is the total product? 60 kg. So 67 minus 60. So 7 kg is a marginal product. So let's do the sums based on this.